Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station update. And on board the crew of Expedition 30 continues a very busy week of experiment and maintenance work. They are being led by Expedition 30 Commander Dan Burbank, NASA astronaut, and joining him are Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov there on the left and Anatoly Ivanishin on the right. As mentioned before, the crew has had a very busy week, which started off at a running pace on Monday. Commander Burbank spent his day installing some alignment guides and working on the combustion integrated rack and the fluids integrated rack, and then doing some work on the waste and hygiene compartment, which is part of the waste reclamation system on board the station. He then later did a treadmill kinematics experiment before moving on to do some work with the minus 80 degree laboratory freezer, or MELFI. Anton Shkaplerov started a human research facility Holter monitor setup, which was a battery-powered electrocardiogram that accurately measures the heart rate of crew members over an extended period of time, typically about 24 hours. He also changed out a dust collector filter cartridge on the Zvezda service module, which is one of the Russian segments. His fellow crewmate Anatoly Ivanishin, we have some video of him working out on Monday on the ARED device, also did some dust collector filter changes, but he worked on the Zarya module, and then did a monthly inspection of the Tevis, which is one of the treadmills on board the station, for doing some further work with the air purification system.
Ready, copy.
Okay, the old one, serial number 048-0194.
And following all this busy work on Monday, the crew continued their pace on Tuesday, doing an emergency egress drill, which helped familiarize them with the location of all of the emergency equipment on board the station, including any necessary hatches and passageways, including their evacuation route. Commander Burbank did some work with the integrated cardiovascular ambulatory monitoring system, which helps to determine how much cardiac atrophy the astronauts are subject to during their expedition space flights. He also analyzed some water from the water processing assembly, taking a look at the total organic carbon analyzer, looking for any particulates that may exist. Later, he conducted a public affairs event talking with reporters here on the ground. And then moving on to do some work with the Japanese exposed module's robotic arm. Anton Shkaplerov performed the pneumocard experiment, which studies the synchronization of heart activity and breathing factors, as well as the cardiorespiratory system control processes, as part of a suite of microbiology and bioengineering experiments on board the station, as the astronauts often serve as research subjects themselves. He did some maintenance to the Russian coolant system and transferred some cargo from the 45 Progress vehicle, also updating the station's inventory management system. Anatoly Ivanishin was also working on that Russian coolant system, doing a number of leak checks, and then started his own 24-hour electrocardiogram monitoring experiment for doing some preventative maintenance on the ventilation system inside the Zvezda module, also known as the service module. Moving on to Wednesday, Commander Burbank's major activity of the day was the update of the Cuckoo software. Cuckoo standing for the COTS UHF Communications Unit, COTS being the Commercial Orbital Transportation Services, which has companies like SpaceX and Orbital Sciences constructing, designing, and eventually launching their own resupply vehicles to the International Space Station. This update was in preparation for the eventual Dragon launch, the Dragon capsule being the SpaceX vehicle, and will allow this comm unit to provide station-to-Dragon communications, allowing it to send any necessary commands and provide telemetry for the eventual docking. Meanwhile, Shkaplerov worked on the Molniya experiment, transferring some data and tagging up with ground specialists. This experiment looking at optical emissions in the Earth's ionosphere and atmosphere associated with any thunderstorm and seismic activity. The rest of his day was taken up by some transfer from the 45 Progress vehicle, which docked back on November 2nd, and again updating that inventory management system. Evenation continued work on the pneumocard experiment. Again, that is a study of the heart activity and breathing factors while the astronauts are subject to that microgravity environment, before moving on to do some routine replacement work on the Russian toilet system. Then after the crew went to sleep on Wednesday, thrusters on the Zvezda service module fired at about 5:11 p.m. Central Time for 62 seconds. And this was in preparation and was the first of two reboosts that were going to take place on consecutive Wednesdays that will eventually put the station at the correct altitude, all in advance of the December 21st launch of the remainder of the Expedition 30 crew. Moving on to Thursday, Commander Burbank was working extensively with the PACE experiment, which stands for Preliminary Advanced Colloids Experiment. This is designed to investigate the capability of conducting any high magnification colloid experiments while using the LMM, or Light Microscopy Module, and is in preparation for the eventual use of the Advanced Colloids Experiment on future expeditions. Commander Burbank cleaned up some oil residue on any of the lenses inside, removing some of the old hardware and installing some new, and also getting some samples and an LED base ready for the eventual use. He ended his integrated cardiovascular ambulatory monitoring experiment on Thursday, again looking at cardiac atrophy within the astronauts' bodies while they're on board. And in order to do that, he unstowed all the hardware and began downlinking all of the collected data. And meanwhile, Anton Shkaplerov was doing some work with microaccelerometers on board the station, which are investigating dynamic loads that are exerted on the station during any dynamic events such as reboosts. And then was also doing some preventative maintenance to the Zvezda service module's ventilation system. Meanwhile, on Thursday, Anatoly Ivanishin worked on the Matryoshka, an experiment named after the Russian dolls. And this one in particular is a torso-sized object with a number of sensors placed throughout that help measure the ionizing radiation exposure that astronauts are subject to while on board the station. And that, all of those activities throughout the week bring us to today, Friday, where the crew awoke at about midnight Central Time and then had their daily planning conference as per usual, and then had their weekly conference with the Russian Space Agency's flight control team. For today's activities, Commander Burbank is doing some extensive work with the water recovery system and water recovery and management system, taking a look at the waste storage tank assembly and transferring some excess waste into that tank. And also later he'll do an audit of the contingency water container inside that water recovery and management system. He's also doing some extensive work on the VO2max system, which helps evaluate the oxygen uptake of the astronauts before, during, and after long-duration space missions. This includes him setting up the SEVIS, which is the stationary bicycle, and then performing some setup work on the VO2max and thermolab instrumentation. And then after he's done with all of this, he'll remove and discard items from the VO2max consumables kit and then move some items from the resupply kit into that. And there you can see the SEVIS, which stands for the Cycle Ergometer with Vibration Isolation and Stabilization, stationary bicycle on board the station to help astronauts maintain their cardiovascular functions. Anton Shkaplerov started his day with an inventory management system conference with controllers here on the ground, then did some work with the Konstanta experiment, preparing some photography and videos, and then executing that experiment, which looks at enzyme reactions in the micro and gravity environment. Later, he'll do some more coolant system maintenance on the Russian segment before getting some exercise in the TVIS, that treadmill. And then a good portion of his day will be taken up alongside Anatoly Ivanishin as they give the TVIS its periodic chassis inspection, looking at items like belt slats, various nuts, and then the tread belt itself, and then we'll be replacing a few slat screws. Rounding out the crew, Anatoly Venetian did some laptop replacement and activation work in the Russian segment before getting in some exercise for the day and then moving on to that TVIS chassis inspection with Shkaplerov. He'll end his day with some exercise on that TVIS, and then the crew will move into their second daily planning conference where they will discuss the day's activities with ground controllers around the globe. Then they will have their weekly conference with the entire crew and the flight director here at Mission Control. The crew is then scheduled to go to sleep at about 3:30 p.m. Central Time today, ending a very busy week and moving them into a nominal off-duty weekend.